Hi guys, good day again. Praise God to everyone around the globe. Again, today we will continue with our lessons from the Bible. Now, I think that will be very beneficial to all of us. Ano po? So the title of our message for today is 7 Biblical Ways on How to Improve Your Life and Be Attractive. Ayan, napaka-importante po niyan. Kasi if we have a good life and we are attractive, ito po ay isa sa mga factor ng success sa buhay natin. Kaya napaka-importante po na malaman din po natin kung ano yung mga bagay na dapat nating improve sa ating sarili so that anywhere we go, tayo po ay maging highly favored. Amen. Ang mga taong nasa paligid natin. Number one, okay? Be friendly and be cheerful all the time. Amen. Praise God. At nakasulat po yan sa 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16. Be joyful always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances. For this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. So the Bible says, be happy, be joyful, be friendly. Ano po? Be smiley every day because our countenance attracts all or repels people. Pag tayo po ay masayahin, if we are cheerful, joyful, happy every day, we will attract people into our lives. And that is a good personality. Ano po, yung positive-minded po tayo, positive personality, positive person po tayo. We can always attract people who are successful, who are positive also. And we can influence also people who are medyo melancholic and malungkutin. Ano po, may influence po natin sila, matulungan po natin sila. And this is one quality of a person who has a good personality and attractive person. Yung pong mga masayahin na tao. Kung malungkutin ka, kinakailangan mag-improve po tayo dyan sa area na yan. Ano po, if you do not know how to smile or laugh, or take life easy, smile, be happy, be joyful every day, because this is what the Bible is telling us. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16, be joyful always. Amen. Praise God. Laging maging masayahin. Why? Because the Lord is with us. We have a God who's helping us, and we have a God who's providing us everything we need, and we have a God who always listen to our prayers every time we need something from God. At ganun din po sa Philippians, nakasulat din po yan sa Philippians, ano po, sinulat din po ni Apostle Paul sa atin yan. Sabi po, Philippians chapter 4, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Sabi po, magsaya tayo palagi at patuloy na magsaya. Amen. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice, sayeth the Bible. Kaya number one, praise God, napaka-importante to have a nice personality and to be attractive to people around us, and anywhere we go, we must be a happy person, a joyful person, and a thankful person. The Bible says, ano po, give thanks in all things, in every situation, in every circumstance, because this is the will of God for us. Ano po, sa 1 Thessalonians 5:18, be thankful in everything. Why? Because God can cause all things to work together for our own good, for our benefit. Amen po. Praise God. Number two, be clean, be neat, and dress properly. Ano po, kinakailangan lagi po tayo mukhang malinis, dress properly. Pagka medyo lumaluma na po yung damit natin, pagtan natin, maski namumurahin lang, ang importante po the most important thing is we look better. Ano po? Kasi ito pong reflection natin, ano po, sa other people, it attracts people also. Especially when you're in business, if you're a salesman, if you're working in the office, or anywhere you go. Ano po, if you're in sales, and anything na tinitinda mo, whether it is tinapa or isda or whatever, or you're selling condominiums or real estate, be dressed properly. Importante po yan. We are properly dressed, we are neat, we are clean. Ay, pag mahaba na ang buhok, praise God, magpagupit na po tayo. Hindi po magandang tingnan sa mga lalaki ang mga mahaba buhok. Ano? At ganun din po sa mga babae, ayusin din po natin ang ating mga sarili so we can succeed in every endeavor na we will have. Kasi being clean, being neat, and being dressed properly attracts people. Ano po, nagiging attractive din po tayo. Genesis chapter 1, verse 31. Even God Himself, sabi po rito. Genesis chapter 1, verse 31, God saw all that He had made and it was very good. Ano po, ang Diyos po natin, ano po, even lahat po ng gawa ng Diyos ay very good and excellent. Hindi po gumagawa ang Panginoon ng mga basta average lang. No, everything is good, everything is very good. So, the Bible says, we be imitators of God. Gayahin daw natin ang Diyos. So, sa lahat ng gagawin natin, dapat tayo po ay excelente. Amen? Nice and good and everything we do sa ating mga pagtatrabaho, sa bahay, sa opisina, whereas sa ating business, it should always be excellent. Ano po? Customer service should be excellent. Our work in the office, whatever is your job, should be excellent. Dapat ma-please po natin ang ating mga boss, ating mga supervisors and managers, and ang ating mga kliyente. Amen? In doing that, praise God, you will have a good life and you will be an attractive person. Amen? You will have a good personality. Number three, be generous and appreciative to all. Dapat tayo din po ay generous. Hindi po tayo yung kabing ng kabing. No? Dapat marunong to tayo magbigay. Marunong tayo magbigay ng gift. And we can share our blessing to other people. And the more we do that, the people around us will like us. Kasi mahirap naman talaga kasama yung mga taong talagang palaging tight. Tayo po, the more you give, the more you receive. Proverbs chapter 11. These are all biblical, ha? Proverbs chapter 11. Sabi po ng Bible. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 11, 24, and 25. Okay, listen. One man gives freely, yet he gains even more. And another withholds unduly, but comes to poverty. So, pag tayo daw po ay nagbibigay freely, yet we gain even more. Lalo po tayong nakakatanggap ng marami. And sa verse 25, a generous man will prosper. He who refreshes others will himself be refreshed. A generous man will continue to prosper. Kaya generosity, ano po? And liberality is one good character na sinasabi po ng Bible sa atin. The Bible is advising us, be generous, be a giver, be a liberal soul, because a liberal soul will prosper, the Bible says. And we will be attractive to other people around us. That is one good personality na dapat magkaroon po tayo, na tayo ay giver. Ang tao pong palaging tanggap, kuha, hingi ng hingi. Later on, wala na pong kaibigan yan, lalayuan po tayo ng mga tao. People will repel people if we don't know how to give. But if we are a giver, we will attract people, we will attract blessing, we will attract favor from God and from other people surrounding us. So, again, I'm gonna repeat the verse. One man gives freely, yet gains even more. And another withholds unduly, but comes to poverty. Pag nag-withhold daw tayo, lalo daw tayo maghihirap, we will come to poverty. This is the law of God. This is a spiritual law that has been set by the Lord. Now we need to apply in our lives. A generous man will prosper. He who refreshes others will himself be refreshed by the Lord and by other people. Pag tayo daw po ay nakatulog sa ibang tao, nakarefresh tayo sa mga tao may mga problema because of our generosity, ano po, financial generosity, material things, advice, smile, laughter, counseling. If we are generous in those areas, praise God, we ourselves, kung tayo man na magka-problema, tayo daw po ay marirefresh din. Other people and God will refresh us also because anything you sow will come back to you. Anything you planted will come back to you. Anything you give will come back to us in a greater measure. Kaya being a generous person, an appreciative person, is one good trait personality. Opo. Okay? Kasama po yan sa being attractive and having a good life. Amen. Number four, Be knowledgeable and well-informed on important things. Ayan. Kinakailangan daw, marami rin tayong alam. Knowledgeable din po tayo. Hindi walang kalamlaman, hindi walang kalaman-laman yung utak natin. Amen. Fill your minds with the Word of God and fill your minds with important things. Halimbawa, ikaw ay carpenter. If you're a carpenter, you must be an excellent carpenter. Dapat knowledgeable ka as a carpenter. Ano po, if you're an electrician, should be knowledgeable as an electrician. If you're an engineer, accountant, nurse, or whatever is your profession, you must be knowledgeable in your own profession and not only in your own profession, sa mga importanteng bagay. Ano po, in all important things na kailangan natin sa ating pamumuhay. And most especially, you should be knowledgeable in the Word of God. Sabi po rito, Proverbs 10:14. Proverbs 10:14, okay. 10:7-15. Wise men store up knowledge. If you are wise, you will store knowledge in your brain and you become wise. And when you are wise, if we are wise, then we can make good decision in every areas of our lives. Why? Because we are wise, we are knowledgeable, we have plenty of knowledge and information in our brain, in our mind. And this is one trait of a good personality and attractive person. If you are knowledgeable, if you are wise and you are smart, you'll be attractive to the people around you. Mahirap yung nagkukwentuhan, wala ka mga nilang makwento, wala ka mai-contribute, and then tinatanong ka, you're being asked for something and anything, you don't have any idea, laging ewan na sagot, praise. Hindi po tama yan. Dapat we should be a contributor also. And if we are wise and smart, and if we are knowledgeable, praise God, we will attract people. That is an attractive personality also. Amen? Praise God. Okay. Proverbs 13:20. Ano po nakasulat dyan? Proverbs 13:20, sabi po rito, he who walks with the wise grows wise, but the companion of fools suffer harm. So for us to increase our wisdom, our knowledge, understanding, our lahat po ng mga information na kinakailangan natin, we must surround ourselves with wise people, also knowledgeable person also, because we will learn many things from this kind of people. Surround yourself with wise, knowledgeable people and honest people, praise God, and you will gain more wisdom. And, of course, ang number one source ng wisdom is our Lord Jesus Christ through the Bible, our Heavenly Father. Amen? The more principles of the Bible you know, the more and the greater is your chance to success, to succeed. Amen? Ito pang sabi ng Bible, meditate on my words day and night, so that you may be able to do it, then you will be successful and prosperous in your life. Kaya knowledge of the Word of God, knowledge of the principles of the Word of God will help us to increase and to prosper in our lives, and we will be very attractive person also to other people. Amen. Next. Mukhang kukulangin tayo sa oras, okay? Live a moral life. We must live a moral life. Ano ba yung moral, praise God? Yung kagalang-galang po tayo. No, we are not a drunkard. We are not a gambler. We are not an adulterer. We are a respectable person. We live a moral life. And if we live a moral life, we will be attractive and will be a respectable person in the eyes of other people. And you will attract success and favor in your life also, if you are a moral person. If you are, you know, if you're in all these vices, ito po ay nakarepel ng tao, ang swerte po, ang blessing ng Lord ay lumalayo pag napakarami po nating bisyo, paglalasing, pagsusugal, paninigarilyo, drugs, immorality, cursing, pagsasalita ng masama. All these things would bring curse in the life of a person. Kaya hindi po sila makaalis sa hirap, ano po, sa hirap at ikahos ng buhay because of all these vices and their life is not moral. Kinakailang matuwid po ang ating pamumuhay. Romans 9, verse 9-21. Medyo mahaba po ito, no? Romans 9, verse 9-29. Okay, sabi po rito. Okay, praise God. For this how For this was how the promise was stated. Okay. At the appointed time, I'll return and Sarah will have a son. Not only that, but Rebecca's children had one and the same father, our father Isaac. Yet before the twins were born or had done anything good or bad in order that God's purpose in election might stand, not by works, but by him who calls, she was told the older will serve the younger. Ang sinasabi lang po dito, medyo mahaba po itong verse, no? Yung paliwanag ko na lang po. Nagkaroon po ng dalawang anak si Isaac. One is Jacob and one is Esau. Ano po? Si Jacob po lives a moral life. Matuwid po ang kanyang pamumuhay. Kaya siya po ay umasenso and he was blessed by the Lord. Not like his brother. Ano po? His brother. Talagang medyo rough ang kanyang brother. Kaya in the end, hindi po naging kaya-aya ang kanyang pamumuhay. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Next. Owe no man anything. Mahirap po yung may mga utang tayo pagkatapos hindi po natin nababayaran, we repel people. Ano po, ito po ay negative sa ating personality. Alisin po natin yan. First of all, mas maganda po, we live by faith. We live by cash basis. Ano po, cash basis po tayo. Pag hindi pa natin kaya, if we don't have the resources to pay, do not purchase, do not buy, or do not borrow money just to buy those kind of things. Masama pong habit yan. Ano po? The borrower is a slave to the lender, sabi po ng Bible. And this is a very, very bad trait of a person. Especially if we borrow and we forget. Ano po? Kinakalimutan natin yung mga inutang natin. Nako, hindi po nakakalimutan yan nang nagpahiram sa atin. Kaya every time makikita ka, hindi yung face mo nakikita. Nakikita yung inutang mo sa kanya. Kaya praise God. O sabi po ng Bible, Romans 13:8, owe no man anything but to love them. Lahat ng bayaran, pay all the debts, and then let's live in cash basis. Amen? Para hindi po tayo palaging napipintasan. Amen? Okay, number 7 is be punctual and have integrity in your life. Proverbs 10:9. Okay. Proverbs 10:9, praise God, doon po sinasabi rito. The man of integrity walks securely, but he who takes crooked path will be found. Okay, ang tao raw na may integrity or matuwid, ano po, secure ang kanyang paglakad or secure ang kanyang pamumuhay. Why? Wala ka traso, wala ka utang, walang naghahabol sa'yo. Nobody's trying to run after you to kill you or to put you to jail. Why? Because you are a man of integrity. When you say you're gonna pay, you're gonna pay. When you say I'm gonna come, I will come. You're always punctual. When you say, okay, let's meet at 7, dadating ka dapat ng 10 to 7 or quarter to 7. Praise God, para hindi po tayo nalilate. If we are late, we are wasting other people's time, effort, and energy. And it disappoints people. Ano po, lalo na sa mga appointments, sa mga usapan, sa mga practices and everything. Ito po ay nakadisappoint ng ibang tao. So, we repel people if we are like this. And praise God, hallelujah, be excellent in everything we do. Dapat excellent po ang lahat na ating ginagawa sa trabaho, amen, in our business, in dealing with other people, different kinds of people, we must be excellent. Let's try to be excellent in everything we do. Amen. In doing this, we will attract people in our lives and we will attract success in our lives. Those are the 7 godly and biblical principles on how to improve our life and be attractive to other people. Amen. I hope you learned something today. Ulitin nyo na lang po. I have no more time to review. Ano po? We have no more time. Praise God. If you haven't received Christ as your Lord and Savior, I'm gonna give you a chance to receive Him by following this prayer. Amen. Say, Lord Jesus, today I am giving you my life. I acknowledge you as my Lord and my Savior. Forgive me from my sins. Cleanse me by your blood. And write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life in heaven. Lord, beginning today, you are now my Lord and my Master. And I will follow you and obey you in every areas of my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In your name I pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. If you do that, now you are a child of God. Continue to walk under the guidance of the Lord, through His Word at patuloy kang lumago sa iyong pananampalataya by listening to the Word of God, listening to the videos na we are producing and reading your own Bible. And pray every day. Thank God in all things. Amen. God bless you guys. I will see you in my next video. God bless you. Bye-bye.